So today we are discussing botany chapters. We are discussing in botany some useful chapters for you. That and all we are discussing. Okay, for most important chapters we are discussing. Okay, here first chapter it is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In flowering plants, sexual reproduction in flowering plants we are discussing. So already you know reproduction is nothing but what is reproduction? So production of generally reproduction reproduction you know it is a biological process. It is biological process. It is biological process. It produces offsprings from the parents. Okay, it produces produces offsprings from parents. Okay, so here mainly reproduction is nothing but biological process. It producing offsprings from the its parents. So already we are discussing. So here mainly, so divided into two types: asexual. Another one it is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. See here, reproduction is nothing but biological process. Reproduction is nothing but biological process. It produces in this process offsprings produced from the parent. Okay, it produces offsprings from the parents. Okay, so here mainly it is divided into two types: asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction. Asexual and sexual reproduction. Here offsprings producing from single parent. Offsprings producing from single parent. Here mainly, so asexual reproduction is nothing but offsprings is produced from a single parent. So formation of without formation of gametes or with formation of gametes, without formation of gametes. Okay, without formation of gametes, it producing offsprings. In sexual reproduction, here involving offsprings produced from the two different type of parents. Offsprings producing from two opposite parents or parents. Okay, two opposite parents. It producing two different type of gametes. It produces two different types of gametes. Here two types of gametes. So one it is a male gamete. one it is male gamete, another one it is female gamete, male and female gamete. So both gametes will be fused to form a fertilization. Okay, so fusion of male and female gametes is called as a fertilization. Fertilization result only offsprings. So what we are discussing here, reproduction is nothing but a biological process. Okay, it produces offsprings from parents. Okay, here instead of here we should write so it is the process of offsprings formed from parents. Okay, so again here they are divided into two types, asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, here offsprings are producing from single parent, offsprings produced from single parent. So the formation of formation of gametes with or without formation of gametes. Okay, so the offsprings produced from with or without formation of gametes, with or, here we will write with or without formation of gametes to form a, which one it is, offsprings. Okay, so sexual reproduction, in sexual reproduction offsprings are producing from two parents, means two opposite sex. Okay, two different parent, here two different type of gametes are producing, one it is male gamete, another one it is a female gamete. So here so first we will discussing sexual reproduction, first we will discussing sexual reproduction. In sexual reproduction what happened? Okay, we will discussing in plants. So what type of sexual reproduction, what parts are there in flower contain, what type of parts are there, that and all we are discussing. Okay, so here we are discussing, next one it is in flowering plants. In flowering plants mainly flower, it is a reproductive organ. Flower is a, in for example if you see in flowering plant, so flower it is a reproductive organ, reproductive organ, it is a reproductive organ. Flower is nothing but reproductive organ, flower is nothing but reproductive organ. Okay, so this is we will see in flower, we will see in only so angiospermic plants, angiospermic plants, we will see in only angiospermic plants. Okay, angiospermic plants is nothing but flowering plant. In flowering plant reproductive organ is nothing but what? Flower. Reproductive organ is nothing but flower. Okay, so in sexual reproduction in flowering plant, we are discussing sexual reproduction in flowering plant. In flowering plants is nothing but what? Angiospermic plant, angiospermic plant. In angiospermic plant reproductive organ is nothing but reproductive organ is nothing but flower. Reproductive organ is nothing but flower. Flower, it is a modified shoot. So already you know, for example so this is the shoot system, this is the shoot system, below root system it is there, this is the shoot and root system it is there. Okay, so this is the underground part, this is the above the ground. Okay, above the ground, underground part. So generally this is a root system. Okay, this is a root system, you know, this is called as a stem, means a shoot system, it is called as a shoot system, it is called as a shoot system. Okay, root system and shoot system. Okay, so here root system, it is generally the root shoot system. Okay, the plant, flowering plants, they are divided into two parts, one it is a shoot system, another one it is a root system. Shoot is modified into the so floral part. Okay, shoot system, it is converted into the so floral part. Okay, so floral part is nothing but what, that is called as a so condensed peduncle. The shoot is modified shoot. Okay, this is called as a modified shoot, is called as a peduncle, that is called as a पेडेंकल. ओके इन पेडेंकल इट इज ए मॉडिफाइड शूट. ओके ऑन पेडेंकल सो दिस इज पेडेंकल और इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लोरल एक्सिस. फ्लोरल ओके इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लोरल एक्सिस. इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लोरल एक्सिस. सो फ्लोरल एक्सिस व्हाट इट इज देयर द नोड्स आर कंडेंस्ड. जनरली स्टेम रीजन व्हाट इट इज देयर द नोड्स आर एलोंगेटेड. हियर स्टेम रीजन द नोड्स आर एलोंगेटेड. एलोंगेटेड नोड्स बट इन कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल. ओके दिस इज अ कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल आर फ्लोरल एक्सिस. द नोड्स आर शॉर्ट. द नोड्स आर शॉर्ट. ऑन कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल फ्लवर्स डेवलप्ड. ओके ऑन कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल फ्लवर्स विल बी डेवलप्ड. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लवर. इट इज मॉडिफाइड शूट. फ्लवर इज कॉल्ड एज ए मॉडिफाइड शूट. मॉडिफाइड शूट सिस्टम. इट इज मॉडिफाइड शूट. ओके सो वाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग फ्लवर. फ्लवर इट इज ए रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन. फ्लवर इट इज डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम द मॉडिफाइड शूट. मॉडिफाइड शूट इज नथिंग बट वाट पेडंकल और इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लोरल एक्सिस. और इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए फ्लोरल एक्सिस. जनरली स्टेम विथ वाट इट इज देयर शॉर्ट इंट्रानोड्स आर देयर. ओके सॉरी स्टेम विथ सो एलोंगेटेड इंट्रानोड्स आर देयर अंड पेडंकल विथ शॉर्ट इंट्रानोड्स आर देयर. शॉर्ट इंट्रानोड्स आर देयर ऑन पेडंकल. ऑन कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल फ्लवर्स आर डेवलप्ड. ऑन कंडेंस्ड पेडंकल फ्लवर्स आर डेवलप्ड. ओके सो दट्स वाई ओनली इन एंजियोस्पर्मिक्स. इन एंजियोस्पर्मिक प्लांट सो मेन रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन इज नथिंग बट फ्लवर. मेन रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन इज नथिंग बट विच वन इट इज फ्लवर. नव वी विल डिस्कसिंग सो फ्लवर डायग्राम. ओके सो नव वी विल डिस्कसिंग फ्लवर डायग्राम. वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर. सी हियर. सो इन फ्लवर विथ वाट इट इज देयर. फ्लवर विथ पेडिसिल इट इज देयर. स्टैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए पेडिसिल. ओके दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ए पेडिसिल. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ए वाट इट इज पेडिसिल. सॉरी दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ए पेडिसिल. ओके इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए पेडिसिल. सो ऑन पेडिसिल वाट इट इज देयर. सो इन पेडिसिल इट इज ए स्टैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. पेडिसिल इज कॉल्ड एज ए स्टैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. ऑन जनरली दिस पार्ट इट इज देयर पेडिसिल. इन पेडिसिल टिप रीजन वाट इट इज देयर. सो स्वालान पार्ट इट इज देयर. ओके बल्जड पार्ट इट इज देयर. दट इज कॉल्ड एज ए थैलेमस. दट इज कॉल्ड एज ए थैलेमस. ओके सो ऑन पेडिसिल स्वालान टिप रीजन वाट इट इज देयर. Swollen part that is called as a thalamus. That is called as a thalamus. On thalamus, so generally condensed nodes are there. How many nodes are there? 4 nodes are there. For example, okay. In 4 nodes, so outermost node it is producing a sepal. Outermost node it is producing a sepals. It is producing. This is called as a sepals. Okay, this is called as a sepal. This is called as a sepals. So next point is next to node it is producing which one it is producing. So this is producing petals are producing. Okay, so this is the petals. Next node it is producing petals. So next node it is producing what? This is producing andrecium. This is producing andrecium. So next node it is producing which one it is? This is the gynecium. Okay, this part it is called as a gynecium. Okay, this part it is called as a gynecium. So I will write two more nodes also. It is there. This is the another one it is. Okay, this is what it is, stamens. So here mainly which one it is there? These are all our petals. Okay, so this is all our petals are there. Okay, sepals and petals. So this is petals. these are the petals. So next one, it is what it is there, this is called as a andrecium. This is called as a andrecium. So next, this is called as a gynoecium. This is called as a gynoecium. Okay, so andrecium, another one is gynoecium. Okay, this is also known as a gynoecium. Okay, andrecium, another one it is gynoecium and andrecium. Okay, so next one it is here mainly we are discussing andrecium, another one it is gynoecium. Here this is called as a gynoecium. Okay, gynoecium, another one it is andrecium, petals and sepals. So these two it is we are discussing here, how many parts are there? So one it is pedicel, next one it is a tip part of the pedicel, a swollen region it is there, that is called as a thalamus. So in a thalamus, so condensed nodes are there, condensed nodes are there. In a condensed, first node it is producing sepal. Okay, node generally it is producing leaves. Okay, node region. So for example, this is the stem, the stem with what it is there, so nodes are there, the nodes it is producing leaf. Okay, here condensed peduncle. Okay, in condensed peduncle what nodes are there? First node it is producing sepal, second node it is producing petal, third node it is producing andrecium, so fourth node it is producing gynoecium. Okay, so gynoecium here mainly, so whorls are, how many whorls are there? Whorls. Okay, how many whorls are there total? Four whorls are there. How many whorls are there? Four whorls. So one it is non essential, essential whorls. Okay, non essential, non essential, another one it is essential whorls, essential and non essential whorls. What it is essential whorls? Okay, so essential whorls it is called as a reproductive whorls, reproductive whorls, reproductive whorls, it is called as a reproductive whorls. It is called as a non reproductive whorls, non reproductive, non reproductive whorls, non reproductive whorls. What are their non reproductive whorls? Non reproductive whorls mainly, so it is outermost whorls, these two are outermost whorls. So first one it is first outermost whorl, it is nothing but sepal, outermost whorl is nothing but sepal. So next one it is called as a petals, petals. Okay, so it is called as a calyx, a unit of sepals. Unit of sepals is nothing but what? So five sepals unit, five are present in one flower, sepals are, okay, that is called as a unit of sepals is called as a calyx. Next one it is petals, unit of petals is called as a, which one it is? Unit of petals is called as a corolla, corolla. Okay, next one it is corolla. Okay, it is also known as a corolla. Okay, so sepals is nothing but calyx, petals is nothing but corolla. Okay, so next one it is non essential, we are discussing. Next one it is essential whorls. In essential whorls total how many are there? Two. Okay, so one it is andrecium, andrecium. Okay, so it is a third whorl. Okay, so next one it is gynoecium, next one it is gynoecium. Okay, so gynoecium, next one it is gynoecium, here we will write gynoecium. Okay, so gynoecium, so gynoecium is nothing but a unit of carpels, unit of carpels is nothing but gynoecium. Andricium is nothing but what? Unit of stamens is called as andricium. So it is lost horrel. This is nothing but lost horrel it is. So here what we are discussing in flower, okay, this is a flower diagram. In flower what we will discussing, amma? In flower diagram, so this is the pedicel. In pedicel tip part it is so swollen region it is there, that is called as a thalamus. In thalamus generally four nodes are there, 1 2 3 4. First node it is producing leaf, first leaf is called as a so sepals. Second one it is called as a petals. Next third one it is called as a andricium. Fourth one it is called as a gynoecium. Okay, total four whorls are there, four whorls are there. So this is the flower diagram. Okay, this is the flower diagram. I will explain one by one. Okay, so first one it is sepals. Here we will write, here we will write. So this is nothing but sepals. Sepals. So generally sepals is nothing but what, amma? So here sepals. Sepals are green in color. Okay, it is a outermost whorl. Outermost whorl. Outermost whorl. Okay, generally it is a green in color. Green in color. Okay, outermost whorl and green in color. Generally this is the outermost and also green in color. It is also performing photosynthesis. It is also performing photosynthesis. It is also performing photosynthesis. So this sepals outermost layer green in color, performing photosynthesis. Main function is main function is so protecting in bud condition. Okay, so the sepals protecting, sepals protect in bud condition. In bud it is there, no? See here, so this is the small bud. Okay, this is the flower. The bud covered with what is there? Sepals are there. So this sepals it is also protecting bud condition. Sepals are protecting in bud condition. So generally we are discussing sepals. Sepals is nothing but outermost layer, outermost whorl. Next it is a green color. It is performing photosynthesis. Main function is sepals protect in bud condition. Okay, sepals protecting in bud condition. So next what we are discussing, so petals. Next one it is petals. So what is petals? Petals is nothing but so next whorl. It is a second whorl. Okay, so it is a second whorl. Second whorl. Generally it is a bright color. Okay, these are bright color. Okay, bright color petals. Okay, bright in color. Okay, generally it is a colored petals. Okay, so bright color. Okay, so next it is also mainly it is also helps to the attracting the pollination. Okay, attracting the pollination. Okay, so generally so these petals are bright in color. Okay, are bright color. It is the petals, it is attracting the insects for the pollination. Okay, so generally the petals attracting insects for pollination, attract for pollination. Okay, what is pollination? Attraction. Okay, attracting insects for the pollination. Okay, attracting insects for the pollination. What is pollination? The pollen grains will be transferred from anther to stigma. So it is helps. See, this is the anther. So here to here pollen grains will be transferred. So that is called as a pollination. That is called as a pollination. Okay, so next we are discussing here another one, it is andrecium. Okay, so we will discussing here andrecium. Okay, so andrecium, generally it is a throd horrell. Andrecium, it is a throd horrell. Okay, throd horrell. Next, andrecium mainly, so it is how many parts are there? It is a female reproductive part. This is the andrecium. Okay, this is the andrecium. So andrecium with what it is there? This is the anther, mainly anther it is there. Anther. Okay, so next one, it is filament, it is there, stack like or cylinder stack like structure is called as a filament. So this is called as a connective tissue. It is connective tissue. It is a sterile tissue. It is not a part of it is not involving in reproduction. It is not involving in reproduction. Anther and filament, it is there. Okay, so next one, it is gynecium. Next one, it is gynecium. Next, it is also fourth horrell, gynecium. So generally gynecium with how many parts are there? See, this is the gynecium. So mainly this is called as a stigma. Okay, this is called as a style. This is called as a style. This is called as a ovary. This is called as a ovary. Okay, three parts are there. So generally stigma is nothing but what? Stigma, it is a receptive part. Which one it is receiving? Pollen grain. Okay, it receiving what it is? Pollen grain it is receiving. Okay, it is a flat form. This is, for example, if you say this is the stigma. On stigma, pollen grains. This is the pollen grain. The pollen grains all falling on the stigma. Okay, so that's why it is a flat form of the pollen grain. Okay, stigma, it is a flat form of the pollen grain. Next one is a style. This is the style. Style, it is a connecting between the stigma and ovary. Yes or no? This is the stigma. Okay, this is the stigma and this is the ovary. So both connected by which one? It is style. Okay, style, it is also helps to the, so penetrating the, which one it is penetrating? So the pollen tube will be penetrate into the stylar tissues. Okay, so this is all our flower diagram. Okay, this is the flower diagram. See here what we are discussing. Flower, it is nothing but a reproductive organ. It is present in angiospermic plant. It is present in angiospermic plant. So mainly, so this is the stack like structure is called as a pedicel. Stack like structure is called as a pedicel. A pedicel tip region, it is what it is there? Thalamus. Tip region, thalamus. It is a bulged part or swollen region, that is called as a thalamus. On thalamus nodes, okay, thalamus condensed, okay, all nodes are condensed. Condensed means short intranodes. Here intranodes are short. Okay, intranodes are short. On condensed peduncle, so outermost node, it is producing sepals. Okay, outermost node, it is producing sepals. Sepal is nothing but calyx. Calyx is nothing but a group of sepals is called as a calyx. A group of sepals. Group of means what? So more than three sepals is one unit, that is called as a calyx. Next one, it is andrecium. So andrecium, it is nothing but male reproductive organ. It is nothing but male reproductive organ. Okay, it is male reproductive part or male reproductive organ. It is a third oral. So it is mainly the unit of stamens. Okay, unit of stamens means more than three stamens. It is called as a andrecium. That is called as a one unit. So for example, if you take one stamen, this is the stamen. The stamen with this is stamen. This is stamen. The stamen with what it is there? Anther it is there and filament it is there. So the anther it is separated two lobes. That is called as a connective tissue. That is called as a connective tissue. Next one is gynoecium. Gynoecium is nothing but female reproductive part or organ. Okay, female reproductive organ. So gynoecium, it is also unit of carpels. It is a unit of carpels. He is called as a gynoecium. Carpel, this is one carpel. The carpel with what is there? Stigma, style, ovary. So stigma, it is nothing but what? It is a flat form of the pollen grain. Pollen grain it is there. The pollen grain is falling on the stigma. Yes or no? This is the pollen grain it is falling on the stigma. That's why it is a flat form of the pollen grain. Style, it is connecting between the stigma and ovary. So the ovary, it is a bulged part. Ovary with what is there? Generally ovule it is there. Ovule with what it is there? Egg cell and also synergids, secondary nuclei and antipodal cells. Okay, antipodal cells, we are discussing that one. This is ovule. This is ovule. Okay, this is the ovule. The ovule with what is there? One egg cell, two synergid cell and polar nuclei. Another one, it is polar nuclei, it is called secondary nuclei, antipodal cells. We are discussing in detail in female reproductive part. Okay, so these are all our flower parts. Okay, next we will discussing already we are discussing sepals and petals. So now we will discussing andrecium. Okay, next we will discussing andrecium. Okay, so already we are discussing flower. So flower parts we are discussing. How many flower parts are there? So four flower whorls are there. Four parts are there: non-essential and essential. Non-essential is nothing but sepals and petals, and essential is nothing but andrecium and gynoecium. Okay. See, next one it is. So already we are discussing sepals and petals. Okay. In flower, what we are discussing? One it is sepal. Another one it is petals. Sepals and petals we are discussing. So next third one it is andrecium. Next one it is andrecium we are discussing. So andrecium, it is a male reproductive organ. Male reproductive part or organ. Male reproductive part or male reproductive organ. So generally male reproductive organ, so we will discussing mainly stamen. Next one is microsporangium. Next one it is we will discussing microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis. After microsporogenesis we will discussing pollen grain. Next we will discussing pollen grain. Okay, so first we will discussing stamen. So already we are discussing stamen. This is the stamen. This is called as a stamen. The stamen with so what it is there? Anther. Next one it is filament. Anther and filament. And connective tissue it is there. Connective tissue. So filament is nothing but cylinder, stack-like structure. Stack-like and cylinder structure it is called as a filament. Stack-like and cylinder structure it is called as a filament. Anther it is also bulged part. Okay, bulged part. It is a bilobed organ. It is also bilobed. Bilobed organ is nothing but anther. Bilobed organ is nothing but anther. So anther it is a bilobed. These two lobes is separated by connective tissue. These two lobes separated by connective tissue. These two lobes. This is the one lobe. This is the another lobe. Okay. This is the one lobe and this is the another lobe. These two lobes differentiated by connective tissue. Connective tissue it is sterile. Sterile tissue. It is a sterile tissue. Okay, connective tissue is nothing but sterile tissue. It is not a part of the. It is not involving in reproduction. It is not involving in reproduction. Okay. So first we will discussing. For example, if you take anther, you take transverse section. If you take one blade, and if you take transverse section, this is the transverse section. If you take one blade. And take anther, if you take transverse section, 2-3 transverse section if you take, then you will see what parts we are observing in anther. Okay, so see here how it is there. So when you will take transverse section of anther, okay, when you will take transverse section of anther, this is the transverse section of anther. Okay, in transverse section of anther, so mainly here two lobes are there. This is the mainly anther transverse section. Anther transverse section. Okay, these are the anther transverse section. So this is the anther. If you take anther, you will take transverse section. Okay, you take one blade, you take transverse section. In this transverse section, here we are observing dehiscence lines. What is dehiscence lines? Dehiscence lines is nothing but openings. Dehiscence lines is nothing but openings. Okay, so anther will be fully matured. No, then the anther will be open when pollen grains will be releasing. Okay, it is also lines of dehiscence. Okay, so dehiscence, lines of dehiscence. Okay, it is anther will be fully matured. What happen? Anther will be open now, then pollen grains will be releasing now. Pollen grains will be releasing. Okay, so it is also helps to the lines. Anther contain these lines. It is called as a lines of dehiscence. Dehiscence means what? Opening. Dehiscence means opening. Okay, it is also opening. This lines it is also helps to the open. Okay, dehiscence means opening. Okay, or open. Okay, so here mainly how many lobes are there? This is the one lobe and this is the another lobe. Total two lobes is there. So that's why it is called as a bilobed. Already we will written there, bilobed structure. Okay, two lobes are there. Each lobe contain two thecas are there. How many thecas are there? Two thecas. This is the one theca, that is the another one. Each lobe contain two thecas are there. This is the one theca, this is another theca. This is the first lobe and this is also second lobe. Okay, two lobes. Each lobe contain two thecas. This is called as a theca. this is called as a theca. Okay, so the theca here, this is also known as a microsporangium. Microsporangium, it contain two thecas. So in young anthervit, so this is one theca, not this one. So this is one theca, this is considered as a one theca. Okay, this is considered as a one theca, this is considered as a one theca, this is considered as a one theca. Total four thecas are there. That's why it is also tetrasporangiate. Four total, how many are there? Each lobe contain two thecas. So that's why it is called as a dithecous anther. Dithecous anther, it is called as a dithecous. Two thecas are there, no? That's why it is called as a dithecous anther. Total how many sporangias are there? So how many sporangias are there? Four. One, no, two, three, four. So that's why it is called as a tetrasporangiate. This is called as a tetra. How many? So sporangias are there. So four sporangias are there. That is called as a tetrasporangiate. That is called as a tetrasporangiate. So that the sporangiate contain sporogenous tissue is there. This is the sporangia. Young anther contain what is there? So sporogenous tissue. Here what it is there? Tissue it is there. This is so this is only that one. This is the sporogenous tissue it is there. This is nothing but sporogenous tissue. Okay, sporogenous cells or tissue it is there. Sporogenous tissue. Okay, where it is there? Sporogenous tissue in microsporangium. Okay, in here this is the microsporangium. The microsporangium with sporogenous tissue it is there. Okay, so the microsporangium matured. Okay, so the microsporangium matured is converted into the pollen sacs. Is converted into the pollen sacs. Okay, converted into the pollen sac. Pollen sac packed with pollen grains. Packed with pollen grains. It is also packed with pollen grains. So generally what it is there? It contains sporogenous tissue. It is there. If it is fully matured, okay, for example, it is initially what it is there? So sporogenous tissue. Okay, so sporogenous tissue, it will become a matured. Okay, so one sporogenous cell it is producing. So how many pollen grains it is producing? Four pollen grains. This is the pollen grains. How many pollen grains are producing? Pollen grains. Okay, four pollen grains. One microspore mother cell. Okay, sporogenous tissue. So sporogenous tissue, one cell is called as a microspore mother cell. That is called as a, so for example, if you take this cell, okay, this is called as a MMC, or it is called as a PMC. What is MMC and PMC? Microspore mother cell. Microspore mother cell, pollen mother cell. Microspore mother cell, another one, it is pollen mother cell. Okay, the pollen mother cell through the meiosis, so what happened? It is producing four pollen grains. How many pollen grains it is producing? Four pollen grains. So that's why only pollen sac with what it is there? Pollen grains. Pollen sac with pollen grains. So generally, so microsporangia contains sporogenous tissue it is there. Young anther contain. Young anther with what it is there? Young anther with microsporangia with sporogenous tissue. The sporogenous tissue, it is converted into the pollen sac. The pollen sac filled with pollen grains. When anther is fully, it is matured, it will be, the lines, it will be open, then it is releasing into outside. The pollen grains released into outside. Okay, see here what we are discussing, andricium. Okay, in andricium, it is a male reproductive part, mainly stamen, microsporangium. We are discussing this microsporangium. This structure is called as a microsporangium. Next one is microsporogenesis. What is microsporogenesis? So the formation of pollen grains is called as a microsporogenesis. Then we will discussing pollen grain. Okay, we will discussing about pollen grain. See here, one it is stamen. Okay, So male reproductive part it is nothing but a stamen. The stamen with what it is there? Anther it is there. Filament it is there. Filament is nothing but stack cylinder structure is called as a filament. So anther is nothing but what? Anther is a bilobed organ. It contain what it is there? Two lobes, one and two lobes. It is separated by connective tissue. It is separated by connective tissue. Okay, it is a sterile part. It is a sterile part. It is not involving in reproduction. It is not involving in reproduction. Okay, so next, if you take one blade, if you take transverse section, this is the one transverse section. So this is the transverse section of which one? It is transverse section of anther. In anther, with what it is there? How many lobes? One and two lobes are there. One and two lobes are there. So that's why it is called as a bilobed anther. Each lobe contain how many thecas are there? This is the one theca. This is the one theca. Total two thecas. So that's why it is called as a dithecous anther. Total how many sporangias are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many sporangias are there? What sporangia? Microsporangia. How many sporangias are there? 4 microsporangias are there. So the 4 microsporangias with what it is there? Sporogenous tissue. Okay, sporogenous tissue it is there. The sporogenous tissue, it will converted into the sporogenous cell, tissue is nothing but a group of cells. The cells with what it is there, one cell we consider as a one microspore mother cell. It is called as a pollen mother cell. Pollen mother cell. Okay. Pollen where it is producing from the microspore mother cell. So it is called as a pollen mother cell, or it is called as a sporogenous cell. Sporogenous cell. One sporogenous cell, it converted into 4 pollen grains. Sporogenous cell is nothing but a microspore mother cell or pollen mother cell. One pollen mother cell, 4 pollen grains are producing. 4 pollen grains are producing. That process is called as a microsporogenesis. So total megasporangia, how many microsporangias, how many are there? 4 are there. Okay, so that's why it is called as a tetrasporangiate. So the microsporangia converted into the pollen sacs. Microsporangia converted into the pollen sac. Okay, so here microsporangia, the microsporangia, so with what is the sporogenous tissue? One of the cell, it is act as a microspore mother cell or pollen mother cell. Pollen mother cell. Okay, pollen where it is producing from the microspore mother cell or pollen mother cell or sporogenous cell. So now this is the microsporangia. The microsporangia converted into pollen sac. The pollen sac with what it is there? Pollen grain. So when it is this dehiscence lines, okay, this dehiscence lines opening, then what happen? So the pollen grains will be releasing. The pollen grains releasing into the atmosphere. Okay, so that is called as a pollination. This is only we are discussing in andrecium. Okay, so next class we are discussing first we completed stamen. Okay, in stamen, so anther it is there, the stamen with anther it is there, filament it is there. So we will take transverse section. In transverse section, what it is there? So two lobes are there, anther with the, so each lobe contain two lobes. That's why it is called as a bilobed. Okay, anther, bilobed anther. Each lobe contain two thecas are there. Total how many thecas? 4 thecas are there, but so each lobe contain two thecas, no? That's why we called as a dithecus. So each theca contain one sporangia it is there, that is called as a microsporangia. The microsporangia, how many sporangias are there? 4 sporangias. That's why it is called as a tetrasporangiate. Okay, tetrasporangiate. Microsporangia converted into, when it is microsporangia, anther it is fully matured, no? Then the microsporangia converted into the pollen sac. So this is the pollen sac. Pollen sac with what it is there? Pollens are packed. Okay, pollens are packed. Okay, so before pollen grain formation, how it will be formation pollen grains? The microsporangia, this is the microsporangia with what tissue it is there. The tissue is called as a sporogenous tissue. The sporogenous tissue, so one of the cell act as a microspore mother cell. It is called as a pollen mother cell. the pollen mother cell, so it produces one pollen mother cell, it is producing four so pollen grains by the meiosis, so this is also we are discussing, you know, andrecium. Okay, so okay ma, so today we'll conclude class. Okay, tomorrow we will discussing so next continuation we were discussing, so that is nothing but so microsporangium we will discussing, microsporangium, next one is megasporogenesis and pollen grains we are discussing. Okay, ma, bye.